Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom, and this quick video will show you a fantastic new way to clean out your Gmail, because Google just introduced a new feature that I'm super excited to show you. If, like most of us, you find that you're drowning in unwanted email, Google just made it much easier to unsubscribe from all those mailing lists that you didn't mean to sign up for in the first place, so they stop flooding your inbox. I'm going to show you how it works, and also how to efficiently clean out all the old emails you have already received. As usual, you'll find a recap of the steps at the end of this video, so there's no need to take notes. First, open Gmail in a web browser on your computer like Safari or Chrome, or use the Gmail app on a phone or tablet. Do not use the Apple Mail app or another email app, as most of them won't give you access to these features. Looking at your inbox, open the navigation pane on the left side by clicking the stack of bars on the upper left. In this first section, select More. It will open up and the word More changes to Less. You should now see the new Manage Subscriptions option. Select that and you will see this subscriptions page with an alphabetical list of all your current email subscriptions and an estimate of how often they write to you. All you have to do is click Unsubscribe next to the ones you no longer want. If you're using the Gmail app on a phone or tablet, tap the stack of bars and then select Manage Subscriptions to get to the same place. So that was easy, but here are three important things to know about unsubscribing. One, it only affects marketing emails. It won't prevent you from getting transactional emails like order confirmations or shipping information, so you don't have to worry about missing anything important. Two, unsubscribing is not instantaneous. People often think it didn't work because they still get emails. It can take up to a couple of weeks for the emails to stop, so be patient. Three, unsubscribing only works if the sender is complying with federal regulations. If the email is not from a legitimate organization, don't unsubscribe, just mark it as spam or junk. So that takes care of the future emails from these mailing lists, but what about all the old ones we already got? You can ignore them, but they're taking up space in your Gmail account, and once it's full, you have to pay for more space. So here's how to clean out the old messages efficiently if you want to. Let's pick a merchant who sends a lot of emails and find all their messages so we can clean them out. For example, if we search for Bloomingdale's in the search box at the top of the page, you can see that there are more than 100 emails containing the word Bloomingdale's. We certainly don't want to delete them one at a time, but we could select all the email we found and delete them en masse. But I've intentionally led you astray here. There's a big problem with doing the cleanup this way. If you look closely, you can see that searching for the word Bloomingdale's turned up a bunch of email that is not from Bloomingdale's. These just happen to contain the word Bloomingdale's. So doing a word search and mass delete is very risky because you may accidentally lose the wrong stuff. Luckily, there's a better way. What we're really trying to find is just the emails that came from the Bloomingdale's mailing list. To find those, and only those, all you have to do is open one of their emails like this. Then click on the three dots menu, either here on the upper right corner or in the icon bar above the email. Both work, doesn't matter which one you use. Then on the menu that appears, select Filter Messages like this. A search form opens with the search criteria already filled in for you. In this case, has the words, contains a list, and a bunch of gobbledygook. This is the precise description of the mailing list emails we're trying to find. All we have to do is click Search, and Gmail finds all of those emails and only the emails that originated from that mailing list. If we click forward, you can see that this search found 103 items, not the 113 we found when we searched for the word Bloomingdale's. So using filter messages like these finds all the messages and only the messages that we want to get rid of. Now we can safely delete them. Click the checkbox at the top of the list to select all the messages on the current page. Note that if you see the sort order option here, which may or may not appear depending on your settings, you should make sure it is set to most recent, not most relevant. If the search turned up more than one page full, you will see this text, select all conversations that match this search. Click there, and you have now selected all the emails we want to get rid of. That's 103 in this case, but it works even if there are thousands of them. Now click Delete, which is the little trash can icon up here. Because we have more than a page full selected, Gmail asks us to confirm. Click OK, and then after a brief pause, we see a confirmation message that they've been deleted or are in the process of being deleted. You have a brief opportunity to click Undo if you made a mistake, but if you miss it, remember that you can get them back from the trash for 30 days. You can also use this technique to clean out just older emails from a list and keep only the newest ones. Let's walk through this once again with a different sender inside Climate News. We open any one of their messages, click the three dots, select filter messages like this, and here's the search form again. Gmail has once again filled in the search criteria based on the selected email. So we click search to find all the emails from this mailing list. We have a lot of these, including one from August 30th and one from August 27th. Suppose we want to keep just the most recent ones and clean out the older ones. Notice the filter buttons under the search bar here. If we click Anytime, we can then select older than a week, a month, 6 months, a year, or a custom date range. Let's choose older than a week. Now the two newest emails are excluded from the search results, and we can safely select all of these and delete them. This time, the confirmation message explains that the messages are in the process of being deleted. So it now takes just a few clicks to remove yourself from mailing lists and to clean out hundreds or even thousands of old emails you don't need. As promised, here's a quick recap of the steps. To unsubscribe from any lists that you don't want to be on anymore, in the Gmail app or the Gmail page in a web browser, select the stack of bars on the upper left, then Manage Subscriptions under More, and unsubscribe from any lists you don't want. And then to find and delete all the old mail, open a sample of the type of email you want to clean out, click the three dots menu, select Filter Messages like this. Use the filter buttons if desired to narrow the list. Click Search, and make sure the sort order is set to Most Recent, not Most Relevant, if you see that option. Then select the checkbox at the top of the list to select all the emails on the current page and optionally select all messages that match this search. Finally, click the trash can to delete all the selected email. Once you know how it works, just repeat the process for each company or organization, and in a few minutes, you can reclaim control of your inbox. Easy peasy. And we're done. Thanks for watching. Please like this video if you found it helpful. Feel free to leave comments and questions below, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.mom videos.